Bartenders of Reddit, what are the stereotypes that come with specific drinks people order? Jajabums are ordered by students which just want to get fricked up a sap. Pina colada, you care more about flavor than image. Also want to be in the Caribbean. 30 star martinis, I'm going to be loud and obnoxious all night. And my vomit is going to be neon orange when I've drank 5 of these. One Caucasian please neck but fedora dude ordered about 10 white Russians from me one night and called them Caucasians every time while chuckling to himself every time he came up to the bar. If you pull up a drink you found on Pinterest and it has 25 steps and is more pretty than tasty, I can tell already you are a future I want to speak to the manager type of mom. From my experience, if you order a Bud Light, Miller Light, Budweiser with a shot of bourbon or whiskey, you probably work a manual labor intensive job. Most older women want alcohol with water slash tonic slash soda. Younger women tend to order alcohol with cranberry or sweeter mixed drinks. Younger men tend to order IPAs or craft drinks. I can always tell who just turned 21 due to all the complex sweet shots with fancy names being ordered. Old ladies that want to party usually start with margaritas. I bartend on the weekends at a shot and drink spot, so I don't get a lot variety. Ordering Manhattans while a Nick, because of the novelty, not knowing that it's mostly bourbon then saying it's too strong. Add extra alcohol to my drink. I give them the bill. Why are you charging me for extra alcohol, idiot? Double brandy and coke means you're probably from South Africa. Lit. Usually someone who wants to get wasted for cheap and is going to complain that the drink is not strong enough. Life pro tip for bartenders. Before serving, fill the straw with well tequila. You will never get another complaint about a weaklet. Martini shaken. Not STIR. RAD equals idiot who knows nothing about booze and definitely has no idea what they're ordering. And will most likely not like it. That said, I'm pretty tolerant of most drink orders. People are allowed to like what they like, even if I don't share the same taste. I usually go up to the bartender and order a Coke, but make it look like an alcoholic drink. I don't drink. Bartenders usually understand my plight. Thank you for letting me fit in. When a customer orders a fireball for himself, a Coke for his young friend, some BJ shots for the two ladies with their boyfriends across the bar, and two cosmopolitans for their boyfriends, a damn cool bar fight is about to happen. Any variety of Boilermaker, guaranteed the customer is an alcoholic. I had a guy who would regularly order 22 ounce bottles of some limited run macro brew. He preferred the drink poured over ice with a shot of alcohol added. He also didn't own a vehicle, unless you count a bicycle as a vehicle. Here's to you, voodoo child. Man. I feel like the compliment to this question is what we are really after, bartenders of Reddit. What can we order that doesn't disappoint you and won't make you judge us? CTRL plus F equals gin tonic. Zero result. I love gin tonic, but my friends call me an old man when I order slash drink that. Frick them though. My go-to is a bourbon old fashioned. A bartender once told me this means I'm an old woman from the south. Used to be a bartender in a pub in London. Typical pub. You're selling a lot of drink. The odd sea idea or glass of wine. There was a local gangster type that even the other hard bastards in the pub used to be wary of. Friendly enough guy. But definitely not someone anyone wanted to be on the wrong side of. He drank nothing but bright pink watermelon Bacardi breezes. Taught me not to judge. Vegas bombs. Either having a great time, and one guy is flexing cash with a bunch of friends, will tip well. Or, douch a bag flexing cash around random people he barely knows, will not tip well. Alcohol soda with a splash of Crown will either be an obnoxious white girl or a slender gay man. IPA drinkers are bearded dads who want to ask 15 questions, and try 15 samples. Long Island drinkers are almost always garbage, and bad tippers. There is an entire demographic of female drinkers that don't care what it tastes like as long as it is pink or blue. The woman who ordered a lemon drop is the only person to this day who has screamed at me at work. So I'll say that's a drink for high maintenance assholes. They want an expensive cocktail, and when you tell the price they start arguing with you that it is way too expensive and that they can make it at home for half the price. What about someone who orders a pickle juice shot? Hold the shot. I just want a drink. What does it says? Guessing from the reactions I get when I order an old fashioned. People expect those who drink it to either be old or a fan of Mad Men. I'm neither. I can't believe no one has mentioned a mojito. As a grown man who orders Shirley Temples, I can say the stereotype is usually that I'm joking. I'm not. Jack and Coke. What does that say about me? Cosmo, this person is almost certainly a pain in the ass. Question for bartenders. Do you judge people who order soft drinks? I usually end up being the driver, but feel as though I'm getting judged by the staff/customers at the bar for ordering a Coke, rather than a drink or something alcoholic. Even more so at a proper club, rather than a regular bar. Anyone who orders a drink and says make it strong means that they aren't going to tip. No, I will not give you free booze. This is how I make my living. I always ask if they want to order, and therefore pay for, a double. The answer is always no. You can frig right off, my good sir. The nice people, ones who look around the bar really quick to see how busy I'm before ordering something that needs to be muddled/blended/requires more than 5 ingredients. I want to shout for joy when someone is like, I'll have a mojito, actually this place is super busy, just a gin and tonic. Thanks. Nuts to the group of 10 who will want daiquiris with extra fruit mixed in, a strawberry daiquiri with a handful of blueberries. And how dare you forget which one of us specified this during happy hour rush. Edit, not saying you should never order a fancy drink again. I love mojitos myself. I just mean that it feels wonderful to have someone in the mass of people waving their hands and snapping their fingers at you asking why you haven't made there with extra but no. Gently stirred with a slight bow in the direction of France. Just say, hey, you know, maybe I'll just have something simple. No rush. Though no apologies for people who come into my small dive bar and want a cocktail they found on Pinterest. Looks like this has turned into ask bartenders what your drink says about you. I like mudslides with amaretto instead of Kahlua cause I hate coffee. Amp female. Obligatory, not a bartender, but once in New York City I overheard a dude ordering a 7 C's. Turned out it's a splash of the first 7 things the bartender sees, yep. Instantly judged as an alcoholic. I'll have a lager, too lazy to look at the taps, or you literally don't care what you drink. Long Island iced teas rarely get tips, and are almost always asked to make it strong. It's nearly an entire cup of liquor, how TF am I supposed to make it stronger? Can you make me something fruity, acarine pure amateur hour? May send this back for being too strong. Will probably make out with that creepy regular that drinks Bud Light drafts on the dance floor after one cocktail and a woo woo. Tended bar at a pantropical bistro when I was in graduate school. Naturally, we had a few pre-blended fruity frozen drinks, which were typically served in a hurricane glass with garnishes. One evening a very manly man ordered one, but requested that it not be served in a fagotti glass. Apparently real men drink their mango mambos in proper old-fashioned glasses. Alcohol, Red Bull, usually a bit of a twat and on some kind of drug. On the bright side, they tip well, because they are too off their tits to care about getting change. I bartend on occasion. I don't really stereotype what you order so much as when you order. You need to realize, as much as you may think it's first come first serve, it's not. It's drinks per hour. You want a mojito or anything that takes a bit of time to make. Try not to order it when I have 6 other people ordering. I will put you to the back of the line. You will see those 6 people likely get their rum and coke, whiskey neat, drink, and ginger bombs before I even start on your mojito. My job is to make the most amount of customers happy. If those 6 people have to wait 2 minutes while I get out the mint sprigs, muddle them properly, add more lime and sugar, let it soak a second, muddle again, add the ice and rum, stir, add the club soda, restir, garnish, and serve. They are not going to be happy. If you have to wait 2 minutes while I get all the rest of the easy drinks done, you're not going to be happy. So I can either annoy 1 person or I can annoy 6 people. Sorry man. My job is to sling the most drinks I can. Now sure, if it's a constant rush I won't keep bumping you to the back of the line. I'll probably make yours while taking other orders, but you're not going to get my undivided attention if you order a high maintenance drink during a rush. We turned an outdoor shed into a tiki bar shortly after the smoking ban. We Malibu gave us these little buckets to make fun fruity drinks in as a promotional thing. I was 18, but knew the basics of bartending, and three couples came in and asked for it in those damn buckets. Of course I screwed up my alcohol portions, because the drink is freaking straight booze in a bucket, and all three couples went inside to complain to my manager about my drink making skills and the prices I charged. We gave the buckets away to make sandcastles after that. We also had a bartender who refused to make a Bloody Mary after 4 p.m. Said it was a day drink. If you go to a bar and order grenadine, you might just be Michael Scott. Alcohol soda, you're on a diet. Margarita, you're a pain in my ass. Scotch and water, you're over 50 with heart issues. Orange juice, you're gonna tip me a quarter. Lagavulin, neat. We had a bar nearby that would guess your drink. Basically the bartender would profile you and try to figure out what you would order. He would write it on the drink napkin thing and turn it over after you ordered. If he got it wrong, you got a tiny discount. It was good fun. If you order an old Spanish, you probably have some government job and nickname like Cuta Berger that you hate, but don't stand up for yourself about. Manhattan / old fashioned 40s businessman, Negroni hipster 20 something, Cosmo / Bellini 20 year old girl that asks for something girly. Anything blended, this varies, but they all tend to come off as kind of oblivious to the world around them. Alcohol crown pretty universal. Guinness and Jamo the Irish, of course. Shandigaff shout out to the Brits. Bud Light any man that walks in and says, what kind of drink do you have? Fireball mixed with soda. Had a bartender tell me at a wedding, oh great, you're one of those people. What did he mean, BC? I'm a bar novice still. It, paranoid posts asking how their drink order is perceived. Alcohol water with lime for the sorority girl who wants to cut calories, then drinks 8 of them and gets blackout pizza from the place next door. Long Island iced tea equals let's get fricked up fast. Old fashioned equals either someone who knows their booze really well or not at all and they want to look sophisticated. A platini equals I'm away from the kids for the weekend. Bush Light equals silver is in small town folk. Alcohol on the rocks equals someone who has been drinking long enough to enjoy the nasty burn of watered down alcohol. W no mixer. My city has a very fancy and TBF very good gin bar in it, which stocks around 500 gins and has become a huge destination for hipster tourists and gin obsessed mums. Used to be people coming to my bar would ask for a gin and tonic. Now people coming to my bar ask what gins we have and make me explain every ingredient and the philosophy behind every damn one before deciding. So the stereotype in my city is you're either asking about gin, which means you're a tourist / Instagram nerd, or you're complaining about everyone in front of you asking about gin, in which case you're a local. Few weeks back a dude was second in line for 10 full minutes because the lady in front of him wanted the history of East London batch 2, and he spent the whole time pulling faces at me over her shoulder. Moment he gets to the bar, only thing he says is gin bar has a lot to freaking answer for. Gin a damn drink. If you're a alcohol drinker and you demand obscure expensive alcohol for the clean flavor, you're a victim of marketing. You don't like alcohol, you like alcohol. Which is fine. But pretending like there is a difference between Grey Goose and Pinnacle is one of the lower aspects of my job. I used to work in a bar with an excellent real ale selection. So of course we sold more Carling than anything else, always Pillocks who would shout at the football while tearing up the card drinks mats that I had to clean at the end of the night. Some would complain that we didn't sell enough real drink too. Frick them. Long Island iced tea equals I'm looking to get fricked up tonight. My go-to drink is Bacardi Cola or Cuba Libre. What can you tell about me? I have bartended for more than 15 years. And honestly, the biggest correlation I've experienced is with sports fans. Here, baseball fans equals drinks. Low maintenance. Minimal tips. Football fans equals double whiskey sevens at 9 a.m. As fast as possible. Decent tips is it's pure volume and turnover. Soccer fans equals Moscow Mules. Kamikazes. Anything with 3 or more ingredients. Unless it's a shot of expensive tequila. High maintenance customers. But good tips. I realize this isn't universal, but it goes with the fans and teams in my city. Hi. Can I get a cherry alcohol sour, but like made for a wuss whose friends made her come out and doesn't like the way alcohol tastes? Does it fit the stereotype of a person who doesn't belong here and should just go home? Cause I agree 100%. Whiskey sour is my go-to. Lessie here. I received this in an email with too many forwards to count. In June of 2007. See for yourself if it's still accurate. Bartender psychology. Before you order a drink in public, you should read this. 7 New York City bartenders were asked if they could mail a woman's personality based on what she drinks. Though interviewed separately, they concurred on almost all counts. The results. Drink, drink. Personality, causal. Low maintenance, down to earth. Your approach, challenge her to a game of pool. Drink, blended drinks. Personality, flaky, whiny, annoying, a pain in the ass. Your approach, avoid her, unless you want to be her cabana boy. Drink, mixed drinks. Personality, older, more refined, high maintenance, has very picky taste, knows exactly what she wants. Your approach, you won't have to approach her. If she's interested, she'll send you a drink. Drink, wine, except white Zinfandel. Personality, conservative and classy, sophisticated yet giggles. Your approach, tell her you love to travel and spend quiet evenings with friends. Drink, white Zinfandel. Personality, easy, thinks she is classy and sophisticated. Actually has no clue. Your approach, make her feel smarter than she is. This should be an easy target. Drink, shots. Personality, likes to hang with frat boy pals, and looking to get totally wasted and naked. Your approach, easiest hit in the joint. You have been blessed. Nothing to do but wait. However, be careful not to make her mad. Drink, tequila. No explanations required, everyone just knows what happens there. Then, there is the male addendum. The deal with guys is, as always, very simple and clear cut. Domestic drink, he's poor and wants to get laid. Imported drink, he likes good drink and wants to get laid. Wine, he is hoping that the wine will give him a sophisticated image to help him get laid. Whiskey, he doesn't give a damn about anything but getting laid. Tequila, he is thinking he has a chance with the toothless waitress. White Zinfandel, he's gay. Tom Collins just turned 21. What's the cheapest drink you have? No tip. Give me 2 shots of tequila. Has no idea how many options there are to this request. Requests hypnotic adult entertainer of some flavor. Requests a daiquiri, clearly lost. I work in a country bar. Amaretto plus sour, just turned 22. A group of girls ordering lemon drops will all pay separately with credit cards and not tip. As a bartender that started tending around the turn of the modern cocktail renaissance, I used to care an awful lot about what people ordered. I would serve alcohol sodas with disdain, rum and cokes with a sneer, dirty alcohol martinis shaken so aggressively they would froth. Then I got over it and realized it is just a job. People drink what they like, and it isn't a big deal what I think. Some people don't have the money to order nice brands, and some people do and just really enjoy a cheap yellow fizzy drink. Now I make anything and everything with a smile. I try not to think of the stereotypes anymore. It isn't my job to do that. It is my job to smile and serve what the guest wants in a timely manner. Whiskey neat. What stereotype? AMF, you're a college kid whose sole purpose is to throw up on yourself by the end of the night and not tip a single bartender. Women that drink bourbon on the rocks have low moral standards. Easy picking, but don't stay too long. Train wreck incoming. Yes, I have a note. Created on the slowest of days. Saved in the deep reaches of my phone for just this question. What your drink says about you. Alcohol / soda, F. My friends are ready, but I'm not. Rum / coke, M. My friends are ready, but I'm not. Gin / tonic, it's good enough for my grandma. 7/7 I / F. My dad was in the war. Tequila / soda, I want to be an Instagram model. Margarita, I want a cocktail but I don't. V martini, I'm a fancy wasted. W / ice on the side, I'm a cheap wasted too. G martini, I only drink farm to table spirits. IPA, I think I have a developed palate. Light drink, this is the only thing in my fridge. Bourbon shot, it's been a rough day. Alcohol shot, it's been a rough month. Tequila shot, I don't work tomorrow. Gija shot, I don't work. Cosmopolitan, I binge watch Sex and the City. Manhattan, I binge watch Mad Men. Old fashioned, I want the huge cube to show off. Top old fashioned, I want to impress my date. Chartreuse slash soda, I make my own bitters. Fernet slash coke, I spent a year in Europe. House red, you don't have my favorite red, so I'll take the cheapest. House white, I have to go pick up my Xanax prescription later. Mimosa day wasted is my normal. Bloody Mary all day wasted is my normal. Alcohol slash rocks, do you have Stoli? Alcohol slash Red Bull, I want to make a lot of dumb decisions quickly. Stella, what do you have on tap? White Russian, no. I don't want coffee. Lemon drop, I only care about the alcohol when I know what it is. I tended bar at a crazy, pretty busy beachfront bar in Florida for 3 years. The following stereotypes are based upon my experience, as well as the particular demographics that frequented this establishment. White chicks, alcohol, any brand including well, W slash seltzer or water, and plenty of lime wedges. Tequila shots, flavorful shots, oatmeal cookie, strawberry starburst, gummy bear, etc. Red and white wine, change for $20 bill, cigarette vending machine. Black chicks, margarita, regular or frozen. W slash plenty of salt on the glass rim. Strawberry daiquiri, pina colada, Miami Vice, 1/2 strawberry daiquiri and 1/2 pina colada. Long Island iced tea, Malibu and Coke, Malibu Bay Breeze, white Zinfandel. Not likely to down shots. Note, an issue I often experienced was the request for light ice in the glass, which is no problem. But the customer also wanted the glass filled to the rim. The amount of alcohol I was pouring was the same in either case. And absent ice cubes meant that more mixer, sour mix, soda, juice would be added to the drink, effectively weakening it, which would quite often result in the "I can't taste any alcohol in this drink" complaint. White dudes drink lots of it, any brand. Jack and Coke, alcohol, any brand, and Red Bull. Fireball shots, Irish car bombs, etc. Really, nearly any type of shot. Note, an exception to this is the overly tanned, tightly muscled, UFC watching crowd. Alcohol and cranberry W slash lime wedge, kindest range, but true. Black dudes, Hennessy and Coke slash Red Bull, Remy Martin and Coke, Long Island iced tea, Blue Long Island iced tea, Grateful Dead version of Long Island iced tea, Grey Goose or Ciroc and Red Bull slash Coke. Not really a shot downing type of crowd. Tourists of any ilk, Bahama Mama, Planters Punch, Maytay. I use the exact same recipe to make all of these cocktails, but no one ever complained. The non-mixologist type bartender's credo, when in doubt, make it red, then send it out, really works. College kids, spring break, anything, everything. My favorite drink is Southern Comfort and Cherry Coke. What does that say about me? Pink drink? No. I can't drink this. Too gay. I'm not gay, I work at Harpoon in Boston and there really still are some people too afraid of being emasculated because of the color of drink they drink. Just make me something yummy, early 20s girl that's going to flirt with me and everyone else in the bar and get carried out by 10 p.m. I'm a bartender, not a chef. Just order a freaking drink, Tiffany. Gin and tonic drinkers are virtually always over the age of 50, and if they want real gin, there's a good chance they are cheap tippers. Not many people talking about wine. Chardonnay, I'm a lady over 35, and I don't like change. Moscato slash Prosecco, I actually hate wine. Rose, I wish I liked wine. White Zin Cougar. Pinot Noir Sideways is my favorite movie. Champagne, I'm trying to impress someone, or I'm a rapper. Chuastramina. Pronounced incorrectly, I think this is drink. Cabernet Sauvignon. And you actually say I'll have the Cabernet Sauvignon and overpronounce Sauvignon? One fancy wine, please. Malbec, I know what tannins are, and I like them. Riesling, I know what tannins are, and I do not like them. Sherry or port, I'm an 80-year-old woman who could kick your ass. Why does it seem like everyone only has one drink order? Sometimes I like drink. Hazy IPAs are my favorite, but drink is drink. Sometimes I like fruity rum drinks. Hello Rum Runner. And sometimes I like something different, like an Angry Mule, 100% Agave Silver Tequila, Lime, Jalapeno, Ginger drink. Expand your horizons. People. Shot of rye. You're probably a fast gun who'll clear leather like lightning. Quicker than anyone else in the territories. Any brand name liquor on the rocks with a splash of soda means it's a person between 55-65 with decent money. They usually tip pretty well. If I'm asked about the malty flavor or mouthfeel of every IPA we have, it's a hipster in their 20s trying to be cool. If they ask for any kind of shooter, at my bar at least, not a college bar, they're 30, 35, unhappy with their life, and wishing to go back to college. Often they are trying to seem fun, young, and hip to the other people at the bar. IDK what it is about moms and margaritas, but they go together like PB&J. People who order double sometimes get mad that their drink is double the price, /. Make sure to like and subscribe so we can watch together.